Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. In this video, we'll be giving you a complete review and guide on dining at Jay Fai, as well as giving you our personal experience. Quick disclaimer, the footage we recorded was back in November 2019, so there was no pandemic at this time. Hence why there's no face masks, social distancing, etc. Before we begin, feel free to subscribe, hit the notification button, and leave a like to support our channel. To be perfectly honest, I never heard about Jay Fai until Fong was watching her episode on Netflix. And after seeing it, I just thought, how does one person keep this up for so long, all of their life? Knowing about this place's reputation, it was clear to us that we had to make reservations, no exceptions. Around mid-August, we sent out some emails to Jay Fai and we tried to make a reservation for November, only to be rejected. They're only open for reservations from September onwards. And then September came, and I sent the exact same email, and guess what? I got a reply saying that they're fully booked for September, October, November, and that their next availability is from December onwards. We literally had no other choice, so the three of us decided to try the walk-in queue and see how it went.
So that more or less means that we're gonna have to queue up for about 2 hours out in the sun.
Yeah, that was me about 2 years ago. I was being very optimistic that morning. Boy, was I wrong. Their walk-in queue starts at 12 p.m. and they open at 2 p.m. So we arrived at the restaurant at around 12:30 p.m. Upon arrival, we noticed already that there was a lot of tourists and a lot of locals. So we went ahead and signed up our names. By the time that we were signed up, we were 45th on the list, which doesn't seem too bad. By 1 p.m, the restaurant was fully booked for the evening, which is crazy. For some reason, we thought that since they open at 2 p.m, it shouldn't take more than an hour for them to get to number 45. About 3 hours into waiting, the line only moved up to number 9. And you're wondering, what the hell did we do for 3 hours? Well, we watched the queues build up, we stood and admired Jay Fai and her cooking skills, we watched the staff prep all the seafood and vegetables before opening, so to be honest, the 3 hours of sitting around wasn't so bad. At this point, we were very hungry and we decided to go around Bangkok for a bit of sightseeing and had some small snacks. Fast forward another hour and a half, it was 5 p.m. We made our way back to the restaurant and found out that the number has moved up to 30. We lost our patience at this stage and then we decided to go to the hotel next door, where they had a coffee shop just on the ground floor. Here we ordered some mango sticky rice and a Thai tea just to keep our hopes up while we are waiting for our turn. And then all of a sudden, one of the workers were just calling out a flurry of numbers, from number 30 to 42. I'm guessing these customers must have gave up and moved on. And then we seen a few customers who were very unhappy about the situation. They were starting to complain to the staff. And honestly, there was nothing the staff could really do at this stage because the numbers were called out and the other customers were waiting for their turn and they are getting hungry, including ourselves. Around 6:30 p.m, we were finally called, but only to order our food. Our table wasn't exactly available yet, so we each ordered a crab omelette, portion of drunk noodles, and tom yum soup.
We ended up ordering about 2 crab omelettes, 1 drunken noodles, and 1 tom yum goong. And the great thing is you can get it in a mild spiciness or Thai spiciness. Clearly we went for the mild spiciness because we can't handle the heat in this country. So yeah, we've finally gotten our order in and that only took us more than 6 hours actually. Yeah, 6 hours and 10 minutes we finally got our order. Finally inside. After we ordered around, was it 20 past?
Yeah, 40 minutes.
Yeah, so about 40 minutes after we've ordered, we're actually here now at 7 p.m. So in total, we've waited 7 hours. We still didn't get our food yet, so probably another half an hour. So 7.5 hours in total. We're only number 44 as well. No, 45. Sorry. We're only number 45. That saves a lot.
Another 45 minutes, then we were finally served. I've never been so happy to see food arrive at the table. This is by far the longest I've ever waited to eat at a restaurant. In total, from 12:30 to 7:45, we waited over 7 hours. One may think that the omelette would be greasy due to the amount of oil used in the cooking process, however, the omelette didn't taste greasy at all. Once you cut through the thin crispy outer layer, you are then met with a fluffy egg which coats a generous amount of crab chunks. We have never tasted an omelette this good before. Served on the side is chili sauce, which enhances the flavor. However, it wasn't required as the dish was already flavorful. Next up is tom yum. The aroma from the lemongrass, galangal, and kaffir lime leaves was enough to make your mouth water. There was a perfect blend of sweet, hot, and sour. Through the clear broth, you can see an abundance of different seafood, from jumbo prawns, squids, and chunks of fish, along with some mushrooms. Last but not least was the drunken noodles. This dish contains a wok hei, which is the magical smoky char flavors. The experience overall was definitely unforgettable and well worth the wait. So this is the only advice that I'm going to give you, and that is try to get a reservation as soon as possible or as early as possible, unless you don't mind waiting hours constantly worrying that your number doesn't pass. You heard us say this many times through the video that it was worth the wait, and it really really was. You guys should come prepared, just in case that you are going to wait that long, you may as well bring some water or some food or snacks with you, so you don't get too hungry. And if you can't get a reservation in any way after trying for months in advance, then my only advice is to get there as early as possible. I'm really not sure what time they'll let you put your name down, but it's always worth the shot of getting there earlier before the crowd. Alright, so that's the end of our video guys, I really hope you enjoyed it. I also hope that we provided enough information and enough context so that you can prepare your own trip next time when you go to Thailand. For more content like this, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to hit the like button, and also to leave a comment and leaving your own experience, because we would love to hear how it went for you. And I'll see you guys next time.